entertain conjecture of a time when creeping murmur and the pouring dark fills the wide vessel of the universe. From camp to camp, through the foul womb of night, the hum of either army stilly sounds, that the fixed sentinels almost receive the secret whispers of each other's watch. Fire answers fire, and through their paly flames, each battle sees the other's umbered face. Steed threatens steed in high and boastful neighs, piercing the night's dull ear. And from the tents, the armorers, accomplishing the knights with busy hammers, closing rivets up, give dreadful note of preparation. The country cocks do crow, the clocks do toll, and the third hour of drowsy morning name. Proud of their numbers and secure in soul, the confident and overlusty French do the low-rated English play at dice, and chide the crippled, tardy-gated knight, who like a foul and ugly witch doth limp so tediously away. The poor condemned English, like sacrifices by their watchful fires, sit patiently and inly ruminate the morning's danger. And their gesture sad, investing lank lean cheeks and war-worn coats, presenteth them unto the gazing moon so many horrid ghosts. Oh, now, who will behold the royal captain of this ruined band, walking from watch to watch, from tent to tent? Let him cry praise and glory on his head. For forth he goes and visits all his host, bids them good morrow with a modest smile, and calls them brothers, friends, and countrymen. Upon his royal face there is no note how dread an army hath enrounded him, nor doth he dedicate one jot of colour unto the weary and all-watched night, but freshly looks, and overbears a taint with cheerful semblance and sweet majesty, that every wretch, pining and pale before, beholding him, plucks comfort from his looks. A largesse, universal like the sun, his liberal eye doth give to everyone, thawing cold fear, that mean and gentle all behold, as may unworthiness define. A little touch of Harry in the night. This day is called the Feast of Crispian. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand a tiptoe when the day is named, and rouse him at the name of Crispian. He that shall live this day and see old age will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say, "Tomorrow is Saint Crispian." Then will he strip his sleeve and show his scars and say, "These wounds I had on Crispin's day." Old men forget, yet all shall be forgot, but he'll remember with advantages what feats he did that day. Then shall our names, familiar in his mouth as household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester, be in their flowing cups freshly remembered. This story shall the good man teach his son, And Crispin Crispian shall ne'er go by from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother. Be he ne'er so vile, this day shall gentle his condition. And gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves accursed they were not here, and hold their manhoods cheap whiles any speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day. Now, soldiers, march away! And how thou pleasest God, dispose the day.